So hello everyone. So in the last discussion we discussed about the what is Beer-Lambert's law and the what are the how to derive the Beer-Lambert's law and the corresponding limitations in this manner. So basically UV spectroscopy the main principle of UV spectroscopy is Beer-Lambert's law. So according to Beer-Lambert's law, absorption values are directly proportional to concentration. So but we have some limitations like this. Always we have to use the homogeneous radiation towards the homogeneous solution in order to determine the absorption value. And if a solution actually having any kind of turbidity or any kind of dust particles, so then there is no proper absorption value. Always we need actually a very transparent solution only, and always we have to use the incident monochromatic radiation only. Then and basically this Beer-Lambert's law useful to only for the diluted solution. It is not applicable for the concentrated solution. So all these things we already discussed. So in today's session I am going to show you what are the instrumentation of the UV visible spectroscopy. So generally there are two different types of UV visible spectrophotometers are available. So one is actually called single beam spectrophotometer, other one actually called double beam spectrophotometer. So let us see one by one. And this is the block diagram of the single beam spectrophotometer. So this is the block diagram. So what are the components are there? The first thing actually, there is a light source. So in the case of UV visible spectroscopy, we have two different types of radiations. One is actually UV radiation and the other one actually visible radiation. So in order to generate greater than 375 nanometers, what is the meaning of greater than 375 nanometers? That means like 400, 500 or 600, something like that. That means basically if you want to generate visible light, we have to use tungsten filament lamp as a source of radiation. Or if you want to generate less than or below 375 nanometers. So what is the meaning of less than 375 nanometers? Like 200 nanometers or 220 or 320, something like that. If you want to generate less than 375 nanometers, that means in order to generate UV radiation, we have to go for the hydrogen deuterium lamp as a source of radiation. So then this light actually goes towards the monochromator. So this monochromator actually is a combination of entrance slit, grating and exit slit. That we will see in the next slide. So this the main purpose of this monochromator actually, this monochromator actually sending a single wavelength light toward the sample like this. It is actually splitting the radiations into different parts. Always it is useful to send the unipolarized. So monochromator means singly polarized light towards the unknown sample. So that light actually goes to the sample holder like this, and then this sample, depending on the nature of the molecule, it absorbs some particular radiation. The remaining radiation actually coming outside. So that is actually called transmitted radiation, and this is actually called incident radiation. So this transmitted radiation goes to the one of the photo resistor and then amplifier, and followed by these two things actually detecting the how much amount of radiation absorbed by the sample and how much amount of radiation actually coming outside. So that is actually we will see kind of some kind of output value in the form of absorption spectrum like this. On the x-axis wavelength and y-axis absorbance values. So we will get corresponding absorption spectrum in this manner. So this is actually single beam spectrophotometer. So the disadvantage of this one actually, if you want to use any reference sample, so first time we have to introduce a reference sample and we have to measure the absorption value. In the second time we have to use the unknown sample. This is actually reference and this is actually unknown solution. So first time we have to use the reference solution and we have to identify the what is the corresponding absorption for the reference compound. Then you have to compare the unknown solution, then you have to use the unknown solution second time. Again you have to get the corresponding absorption spectrum, then we have to compare the both the absorption spectrums. So that is then the case of single beam photophotometer. But we have another technique. So this is actually called double beam spectrophotometer. So this is actually called double beam spectrophotometer. So in this case also initially we have a light source like this. So this light source is generating the corresponding radiation. So depending upon the light source, if it is the tungsten filament lamp, greater than 375. If it is the hydrogen deuterium lamp, it will generate less than 375. So then this radiation actually enters into the firstly and translate. So this entire thing actually called monochromator. This entire thing actually called monochromator. So first light enters into the lens in this manner. So due to the lens, this goes to the this radiation goes to the one of the grating surface like this. So this is the grating. So this is the grating surface. So this grating actually dividing that light into different types of radiations in this manner. So finally, all these radiation goes to the exit slit. This is actually called exit slit. So this exit slit actually allows the required wavelength towards the unknown sample. We can fix what the wavelength we need. Whether we need 420, okay, adjust up to the 420. It is allowing only 420 to the unknown sample. Like this, this exit slit actually sending only one type of radiation towards the unknown sample. But before that, so that radiation actually goes to the one of the chopper. So chopper means it is actually cutting the radiation into half parts. So this is single radiation, but here this is actually converting into two different lines like this, two different radiations like this. So one of the radiation actually goes to the sample. What are the sample? We have unknown sample, and the other part actually goes to the reference. That means in this technique, at a time we can able to use a reference compound as well as sample compound. No need to go for the two different measurements. In the previous example, first time we have to measure the absorbance value for the reference compound, and second time we have to measure the absorbance value for the sample compound. But here, so at a time we can able to send the radiation towards the reference compound as well as sample compound. So here also there is a transmit radiation, here also there is a transmit radiation. Here this sample actually absorbing some of the radiation from the incident radiation, and the reference compound actually absorbing corresponding fixed amount of radiation. So both detectors, this is the detector 1, this is the detector 2. So both are actually sending the signals to the this amplifier. So this amplifier actually collecting signals from the reference compound as well as from the unknown compound. So generally from the unknown signal, there is a lot of difference in the intensity of the incident radiation, whereas from the reference compound generally there is no much difference. So all these changes actually detected by this amplifier, and finally this amplifier actually producing a display like a absorption spectrum in this manner. So like this, we have a two different types of spectrophotometers, UV visible or spectrophotometers. One is actually single beam spectrophotometer, and this one actually double beam spectrophotometer. And this double beam spectrophotometer actually having more advantages when compared to the single beam spectrophotometer. So in the next class, we will discuss about the some of the qualitative applications and quantitative applications of the UV visible spectroscopy based on the Beal Lambasta and all those things. So this is all about today's session. So in this session, just we discussed about the what is the instrumentation of the UV visible spectroscopy, a block diagram of the single beam spectrophotometer or double beam spectrophotometer. So this is all about that. If you have any doubts, please contact me. I will try to explain the all your doubts. So thank you. Thank you, one and all.